Hello and welcome to the Daily Vision Bible. I'm Robbie Yates. You know, I started off the Daily Vision Bible as a challenge to myself, an attempt to read the Bible with an aspect of public accountability should I ever miss a date with God's Word. But as I've been reading it, I've begun to realise how much pleasure is to be found in reading the Bible. Little nuggets of information that cause us to question our beliefs more and yearn for a deeper understanding of God and His Word. Reading Deuteronomy chapter 9 today, let us open God's Word with prayer. Lord, I ask that as I read your Word, you reveal something new to me. I also ask that as people hear your Word, they come to better understanding of you. Amen. Hear Israel, you are to pass over the Jordan today, to go in and to remove nations greater and mightier than yourself, cities great and fortified up to the sky, a people great and tall, the sons of Anakim, whom you know, and of whom you have heard say, who can stand before the sons of Anak? Know therefore today that Yahweh your God is he who goes over before you with a devouring fire. He will destroy them, and he will bring them down before you. So you shall drive them out and make them perish quickly, as Yahweh has spoken to you. Don't say in your heart, after Yahweh your God has thrust them out from before you, saying, for my righteousness Yahweh has brought me in to possess this land. Because Yahweh drives them out before you because of the wickedness of these nations. Not for your righteousness, or for the uprightness of your heart, do you go in to possess their land. But for the wickedness of these nations, Yahweh your God does drive them out from before you, and that he may establish the word which Yahweh swore to your fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob. Know therefore that Yahweh your God doesn't give you this good land to possess for your righteousness, for you are a stubborn people. Remember and don't forget how you provoked Yahweh your God to wrath in the wilderness. From the day that you left the land of Egypt until you came to this place, you have been rebellious against Yahweh. Also, in Horeb, you provoked Yahweh to wrath, and Yahweh was very angry with you to destroy you. When I had gone up onto the mountain to receive the stone tablets, even the tablets of the covenant which Yahweh made with you, then I stayed on the mountain 40 days and 40 nights. I neither ate bread nor drank water. Yahweh delivered to me the 2 stone tablets written with God's finger. On them were all the words which Yahweh spoke with you on the mountain after the middle of the fire in the day of the assembly. It came to pass at the end of 40 days and 40 nights that Yahweh gave me the 2 stone tablets, even the tablets of the covenant. Yahweh said to me, arise, get down quickly from here, for your people, whom you have brought out of Egypt, have corrupted themselves. They have quickly turned aside out of the way which I commanded them. They have made a molten image for themselves. Furthermore, Yahweh spoke to me, saying, I have seen this people, and see, it is a stubborn people. Leave me alone, that I may destroy them, and blot out their name from under the sky. And I will make of you a great nation, mightier and greater than they. So I turned and came down from the mountain, and the mountain was burning with fire. The 2 tablets of the covenant were in my 2 hands. I looked, and I saw, you had sinned against Yahweh your God. You had made for yourselves a molten calf. You had turned aside quickly out of the way which Yahweh had commanded you. I took hold of the 2 tablets and threw them out of my 2 hands and broke them before your eyes. I fell down before Yahweh as at the first 40 days and 40 nights, and I never ate bread nor drank water because of all your sin which you sinned in doing that which was evil in Yahweh's sight to provoke him to anger. For I was afraid of the anger and hot displeasure with which Yahweh was angry against you to destroy you. But Yahweh listened to me at that time also. Yahweh was angry enough with Aaron to destroy him, and prayed for Aaron also at the same time. I took your sin, the calf which you had made, and burned it with fire, and crushed it, grinding it very small, so that it was as fine as dust. I threw its dust into the brook that descended out of the mountain. At Taberah, at Massah, and at Kibroth-Hattaavah, you provoked Yahweh to wrath, when Yahweh sent you to Kadesh Barnea, saying, go up and possess the land which I have given you. you rebelled against the commandments of Yahweh your God, and you didn't believe him, nor listen to his voice. You have been rebellious against Yahweh from the day that I knew you. So I fell down before Yahweh the 40 days and the 40 nights that I fell down, because Yahweh had said he would destroy you. I prayed to Yahweh and said, Lord Yahweh, don't destroy your people and your inheritance that you have redeemed for your greatness, that you have brought out of Egypt with a mighty hand. Remember your servants, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Don't look at the stubbornness of these people, nor at their wickedness, nor at their sin. Lest the land you brought us out of should say, because Yahweh was not able to bring them into a land which he promised to them, and because he hated them, he has brought them out to kill them in the wilderness. Yet they are your people, and your inheritance, which you brought out by your great power, and by your outstretched arm.